To install MODX, first you go to modx.com and let's scroll down and find the download MODX button. We click on it and then MODX wants us to subscribe to the newsletter, but if we click here at the bottom, then we don't need to. Then we are greeted with the download MODX page, and here you have the versions. I suggest you install the latest version. The only time I don't need the latest version is when I'm moving a MODX site, and the MODX site I'm moving is not the latest version. So we have here a couple of packages. Just install traditional is the one I use more often, and now it's downloading. Okay, now that MODX has been downloaded, I'm going to move it to my desktop. It's over here downloaded. Okay, so I moved this zip into the folder on my desktop, and now I have to upload it on my server, and I'm going to use FileZilla. Now, what you can do is either extract the zip here in the folder and then upload all the files via FileZilla, or you can upload the zip inside FileZilla and then extract it via your terminal, your server-side terminal on your site. And it is best to extract it on your server rather than unpacking all the files here and uploading them manually on FileZilla. And I'll tell you why. Because this zip contains all the MODX installation, if we upload it file by file, let's say, for example, we're uploading it and suddenly your uncle starts streaming My Little Pony in 4K, which shocks the internet, and one half of a file isn't uploaded. And then when you try to install MODX, since that file is missing, you get some weird error about corrupted files and you have to upload the files all over again, but you don't know which file it is. So the recommended way is to upload the zip, and this is what we're going to do in this tutorial. To somehow go into the backend terminal and use that. And I'm going to use PuTTY for this technique. Okay, so this is PuTTY. And what you could do is you enter your host name, and then you open a session with your backend, and then you enter your username and password, which is what I'm going to do. And then you are inside the backend. All right, so I entered my host name, my username, and my password. They're the same as the SFTP. Now I'm inside the home folder, which is this folder over here. I am in the root of my cloud, but you know, we're just pretending this is a shared hosting. So my zip is inside the www folder. So what I gotta do is type sd www. What sd means is go into the directory, click enter, and now I'm inside the www directory, which is this directory over here that we are seeing on FileZilla. To connect it on the backend via the terminal, what I want you to do first is I want you to go into your MODX folder, and then I want you to unzip MODX inside your computer. And this is not going to result in any loss of files because you're extracting on your own computer and you don't need any internet. So you can just click extract to MODX. Oops, it's fine. And this folder MODX, so we want to open the folders, and we want you to go to all the files. So all the files of MODX are in folders are connectors, core, manager, setup, all of that. So I want you to copy that, and I want you to add to archive. And the reason we're doing this is because when you download MODX, it goes with a root directory. You won't be able to unzip it on the server if we use that. So let's change this to modx.zip, and let's zip them up. Okay, now I want you to take this zip and then just slide it over to the root of your site. You can also install it in a subfolder, but we prefer the root. Look how quickly it uploads. All right, now that it's uploaded, I want you to go to your PuTTY, and then I want you to just first check that you're in the correct folder. Okay, so we have folder and MODX. Now we want to unzip all of the files inside the zip. And all of the files are going to be these over here. So let's do unzip modx.zip. And there you go. Let's refresh our FileZilla. Now the first thing we want to do is we want to remove this zip because people will be able to very easily hack our website. So we don't want that, and now to remove it, just type rm modx.zip. There we go. Now, The next step we want to do is start installation, and let's do that. So go to the root of your site. In this case, it's going to have this error code, could not load MODX file, and that's fine. What you want to do is we want to navigate to the setup folder, okay? So in the root of your site, just do /setup, and then the installation screen is going to appear. So we want to do choose language, English. It's also translated in a bunch of other languages if you need them. Next. And, you know, just click next. So we're doing new installation, folder and file permissions, they're fine. Okay, send X powered by header. So I usually disallow this option. What this is going to do is add a special header. So when websites such as built with can scan your website, and the headers will say, okay, this website was built with MODX, but we want our website to be as secure as possible. So I uncheck this option, click next. Here you want to add in your database type, host, login name, password, name, and table prefix. So just populate that. You should, if you don't know what those are, just take a screenshot and email your shared hosting provider or contact your database administrator. Okay, I inputted my information. Now let's click test that server and connection. Okay, everything is fine. Now the character set, I think this is the correct one. You can always change the character set after you have installed the site. Now click here, create or test selection of your, okay. So I have a problem. The table prefix is already in use of this database. So what I'm going to do is change the table prefix to 2. You're probably not going to have this problem, but let's try again. Okay, let me try to debug. Okay, so this is also a teaching moment. The problem is I had a previous installation of MODX in my database, but you're probably not going to have this problem. So just make sure your database is empty, but make sure that the database name exists. And then you have to add the default admin username. So for example, let's say our username is going to be, you know, make sure your username is quirky and funny. Don't just add admin because it's not secure. I usually do funny names, like literally characters, or for example, you can do red ponies, your email. So I'm just going to input my email. Okay, and your password, you know, just make sure it is something secure. We're going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Do they seem right to you? Make sure they're the same. Okay, now let's click next. And here, this is the next to last screen. This is going to check whether all of your server requirements are correct. And it seems like everything is okay. So let's just click install and pray we did everything correctly. Okay, that means we're almost done. The core has been installed. Now we click next and then check this. Click here to delete the setup directory from the file system. Now check this so that the setup directory is deleted. Always make sure you have deleted the setup directory. Now some shared hosting providers or hosting providers will not delete it automatically, so you have to do it manually, but we're going to check for that later. Let's click login and there we go. So let's use our username, which is red ponies, and our password, and let's click login. There we go. This is the admin panel and we successfully installed the website. You can go to content, preview site, and you'll be welcome with the screen. If you're welcome with the screen, then everything you did was great. And that's how you install MODX manually.